Where's the rider? What are you doing over there?
Me?
No, Bonnie, oh. Never heard of cursing.
Well, that's on the regular.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah. I mean, is that a news flash?
Hey. See, I told you. It's just on the regular.
It's so normal.
Really?
Tell me
something. That's the point.
Tell me something I don't know.
Look at you, little one, sitting there on your cushion.
Good boy. You're happy.
You get a little extra.
So where did you go? It was great. They gave me this guy with wheels. He came in and gave me all kinds of yummy treats. And then I ran around the store. And they chased me.
Yeah.
And then I kept bonking my head on this thing that I thought was a door. But apparently it wasn't.
He did the same thing. He started to walk out. And then there he goes.
Thank you. Well, what I did on, what, so what I started doing yesterday, what I started doing on Saturday is, I'll start sending my calendar to every Saturday, like, all in, because it has to be about Saturday afternoons. So, if it's missing out, then it's not as bad for her, it's gonna be again, she gets to do it. Yeah, he drives, just like kind of, like, both by AM and PM boys, every weekend.
Well, I'm gonna take you on, take these out and just set them on the floor and we'll get them.
Okay, so like.
At least the amount of times I need to open a door, I'm gonna.
Yeah, so, well, I told him, I said, Becky and Regina both got out. I mean, they may not have been adopted, but they both got out of the pack.
That's what counts.
Exactly, that's how I feel, we should even count the foster.
Almost.
Well, and he had Odin and Striker yesterday, and he, so I sent them back with him instead of Striker, because I had, it's easier to get them. So I was the thing, I was new, I was moving to today, where Barb drives in the morning, so Barb drives in the morning, and Mark drives in the afternoon, so I was short of Barb yesterday, on top of them two people being in the store, so that's what they did yesterday. And then Cindy was gonna come this afternoon.
I'm just gonna watch you, okay?
Cause I just gotta watch.
Okay, why, when I have you, watch it. You're not looking.
Oh. So Cindy was gonna come, so Lynn was coming from 10 to 12, and then Cindy was gonna come from 12 to 13. And I messaged them both last night, and I said, well, one of my regulars is gonna be able to come in, and I said, so you know, we do. And Lynn was like, well, I'd probably like to still come in. I think Lynn was being nosy and wanted to see a different race team.
You look familiar.
Right?
Brian used to be a quiet guy.
Remember that, Brian?
Yeah.
I was just Brian.
I love watching it. You know, when Taylor was still with us, some days I would forget she was there.
Yeah. She was quiet.
But we'd be going on something, and we'd all be like laughing at the storm, and I'd walk towards the back for something, and I'd see her, and she's like, she was quiet, she wasn't coming in, but I'd see her like cracking up.
Oh, so
funny. I thought of her the other day and wondered how she's doing at school.
Yeah. She's another one. Her and Ellie both.
Yeah.
Just fantastic.
Yeah.
And I'm sorry, but my experience with college kids in PAC have not been, they're not reliable.
No kidding.
They're not consistent.
These guys are bad.
But they're both amazing.
And they're both gonna be veterinarians.
I know. They're both just amazing young ladies.
Yep.
They're great with the animals.
Caitlin, she could sit in one kennel all day.
Mm-hmm. Well, but the effect she had on some of those dogs.
She worked with them really a lot. I mean,
yeah.
Through those kind of teaching stuff.
She was good.
I wouldn't be surprised with her if she ended up shifting gears and getting more involved in behavior, animal behavior.
Are you talking to Caitlin?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I wouldn't be surprised.
She's
like a dog around dogs and those, like, okay. okay.
Sometimes
not on this. Like they taught them and they try to teach them. And then when something happens, the cat gets all butthurt about it, like, hey, you know. No, you've been tormenting the dog for weeks. And he can be a super, like, he's a little bit. He may or may not get a seat on that once he's out of the shelter environment, but I will honestly tell you, I think that even if he did still need it to some degree, I don't think he would need as much. He's part husky and he's been there since he was a kid, so he's big, really needs it. He's deteriorating because the longer he's there, the more stressful it is for him, just simply because of the breeds.
Okay,
I think
he
so
might
what
have
else
has
to
be
shown and he's over two.
I think we'll need to figure out. He sort of swept, except
okay, he does really, really well.
Blanket.
Did you have a question?
So I'm going to try to figure out. Because I already slept in there.
Uh-huh.
So I'm just, when he gets out, I'm just going to try to pick up the blanket and
you have
outside and shake.